many countries impose a tax on dividends paid to foreign investors. For example, the US government levies a 15% tax on dividends paid to Canadians. Because these taxes are sometimes withheld before dividends are paid in cash, they often go unnoticed. But their impact can be far greater than that of management fees, which get much more attention. The amount of foreign withholding tax payable depends on two important factors. The first is the structure of the ETF that holds the stocks, and the second is the account type used to hold the fund. Both can be managed to minimize the withholding taxes on your foreign dividends. I'm Justin Bender, Portfolio Manager at PWL Capital. In this episode of the Canadian Portfolio Manager, I'll show you the best ETFs to hold in each account type in order to minimize the withholding tax drag on your foreign dividends. In terms of fund structure, Canadian ETF investors can gain exposure to US, international, and emerging market stocks in three main ways. The first, through a US-based ETF that holds foreign stocks. The second, through a Canadian-based ETF that holds a US-based ETF that holds foreign stocks. And third, through a Canadian-based ETF that holds foreign stocks directly. Depending on the structure of their ETF, investors could be subject to one or even two layers of withholding tax. Level 1 withholding taxes are those levied by the countries where the stocks are domiciled, whether in the US or overseas. Level 2 withholding taxes are incurred when international or emerging market stocks are held indirectly via a Canadian-based ETF that holds a US-based ETF. Specifically, there's an additional 15% US tax on foreign dividends before the US-based ETF pays the net dividends to Canada. The different account types in which you're holding the ETF, such as your RRSP, TFSA, or taxable account, also has an impact on its foreign withholding tax implications. Now that the stage has been set, let's walk through some steps you can take with your ETF investments to mitigate your tax drag. In this video, I'll cover the three main foreign equity asset classes: US, international, and emerging markets. For each, I'll suggest which ETF structures are the most tax efficient for the account type, as well as when it might make sense to break these rules. So let's start with US equity ETFs. As mentioned earlier, most US equity ETFs are structured in one of three ways: a US-based ETF that holds US stocks, a Canadian-based ETF that holds a US-based ETF that holds US stocks, and a Canadian-based ETF that holds US stocks directly. In an RRSP or RIF account, the first structure, which is a US-based ETF that holds US stocks, is the winning one from a withholding tax perspective. Holding a US-based US equity ETF in your RRSP or RIF exempts all dividends from the 15% US withholding tax due to a tax treaty between Canada and the US. For example, if you held a US-based US equity ETF in your RRSP and it distributed $1,000 of gross foreign dividends, your account would have received the full $1,000. Alternatively, you would have lost $150 or 15% of your $1,000 dividend if you had opted for either of the remaining two fund structures. Some popular examples of US equity ETFs with this tax-efficient structure include the Vanguard Total Stock Market ETF with ticker symbol VTI and the iShares Core S&P Total US Stock Market ETF with ticker symbol ITOT. Both funds have lower expense ratios than their Canadian-based counterparts. And based on the current US equity dividend yield of 1.9%, opting for a US-based US equity ETF in your RRSP should save you around 0.3% per year. But as usual, there's a catch. To purchase VTI or ITOT in your RRSP, you'll first need to convert your loonies to US dollars. And even if you use the Norbert's Gambit strategy to reduce the cost of buying US dollars, there will be additional transaction costs. So as an exception to these rules, if you have a smallish portfolio, you may want to stick with a Canadian-based US equity ETF for now. Make sure your RRSP value is well into the six digits before even considering US-based ETFs. Now, if you're holding US equity ETFs in a TFSA, RDSP, or RESP, there's nothing you can do about the withholding tax drag. US-based US equity ETFs, like VTI and ITOT, receive no preferential tax treatment in these account types, so they're effectively the same as the other two ETF structures and will be subject to a foreign withholding tax drag of around 0.3% per year. For this reason, I'd recommend holding either a Canadian-based ETF that holds a US-based ETF that holds US stocks, or a Canadian-based ETF that holds US stocks directly. The Vanguard US Total Market Index ETF, with ticker symbol VUN, is one such fund with a US wrap structure. It simply holds the US-based ETF VTI. Another example would be the iShares Core S&P US Total Market Index ETF, with ticker symbol XUU, which includes ITOT as one of its core holdings. The BMO S&P 500 Index ETF, with ticker symbol ZSP, is an example of a Canadian-based fund that holds the US stocks directly, but its structure is very similar to that of VUN or XUU from a withholding tax perspective. And as an exception to these rules, if you already hold US dollars in one of these account types, you could consider purchasing a US-based US equity ETF to slightly reduce your product cost. Just keep in mind that the foreign dividends will still be subject to the 15% US withholding tax. Now, on to taxable accounts. US withholding tax also applies here no matter which ETF structure you choose. You can generally claim a foreign tax credit to recover the foreign taxes, but you'll still pay Canadian income tax on the full dividend. And as mentioned earlier, a slightly lower product cost is the main benefit of holding US-based US equity ETFs like VTI and ITOT. But since it would take many years for these product cost savings to offset the currency conversion cost to buy US dollars, especially if you don't use the Norbert's Gambit strategy, I'd still recommend holding Canadian-based US equity ETFs like VUN, XUU, or ZSP in your taxable account. As exceptions to these rules, if you already have US dollars available in your taxable account, you could consider purchasing US-based ETFs. Keep in mind, there'll be additional CRA reporting requirements, such as completing a T1135 form each year. As well, if you're a Canadian US dual citizen, you could potentially reduce your passive foreign investment company or PFIC reporting costs by holding US-based instead of Canadian-based ETFs in your taxable accounts. Next, let's look at tax-efficient international equity ETFs for your accounts. When choosing between the three international equity ETF structures for your RRSP or RIF, you can immediately scratch one of them off your list. A Canadian-based ETF that holds a US-based ETF that holds international stocks. This US wrap structure was originally how companies like Vanguard Canada and BlackRock Canada structured their international equity ETFs, and it's how they still structure their US and emerging markets equity ETFs. When this fund type is held in an RRSP or RIF, foreign dividends are first paid to the US-based fund, generating a layer of withholding taxes in the process. The net dividends are then paid from the US-based ETF to the Canadian-based ETF, creating another layer of withholding taxes in the process. The end result is a tax drag of around 0.6% per year. This fund structure can still be seen, although probably best avoided, in ETFs like the Vanguard FTSE Developed All Cap XUS Index ETF with ticker symbol VDU, which holds the US-based Vanguard FTSE Developed Markets ETF with ticker symbol VEA. The remaining two fund structures avoid the second layer of US withholding tax in RRSPs and RIFs, but for different reasons. A Canadian-based ETF that holds international stocks directly allows the foreign dividends to bypass the US on their way to Canada. The second layer of withholding tax is thus avoided, although the first layer still applies based on foreign companies paying dividends to the Canadian fund. In this more tax-efficient structure, the end result is a tax drag of around 0.3% per year. Example of funds with this structure include the iShares Core MSCI EFI IMI Index ETF, with ticker symbol XEF, the Vanguard FTSE Developed All Cap X North America Index ETF, with ticker symbol VIU, and the BMO MSCI EFI Index ETF, with ticker symbol ZEA. And then there's the US-based ETF that holds international stocks. This structure also avoids the additional tax drag when held in an RRSP or RIF, where it's exempt from the 15% US withholding tax. An example of a fund with this structure is the iShares Core MSCI EFI ETF, with ticker symbol IEFA, which offers two additional benefits. First, IEFA has lower product fees. Its annual cost is 0.07%, compared to XEF's cost of 0.22%. Second, IEFA is expected to have a lower tracking error relative to its index. It's currently around 25 times bigger than XEF and can arguably track its index more closely with this level of scale. When holding international equity ETFs in a TFSA, RRSP, or RRSP account, the preferred fund structure is a Canadian-based ETF that holds international stocks directly. This structure results in only one layer of withholding tax, while the others have two layers. So if you're holding international equity ETFs in your TFSA, I'd suggest opting for XEF, VIU, or ZEA. I also prefer the same ETF structure for taxable accounts. When you hold a Canadian-based ETF that holds international stocks directly, only one layer of withholding taxes will apply, and even that one may be recoverable. Compare that to the other two structures. The first one being a US-based ETF like IEFA that holds international stocks, and the second one being a Canadian-based ETF like VDU that holds US-based ETFs like VEA. Both of these are subject to two layers of withholding taxes, and only the second layer of US withholding tax may be recoverable. So again, my vote for taxable account holdings goes to ETFs such as XEF, VIU, or ZEA. If you don't feel like messing around with Norbert's Gambit to convert your Canadian dollars to US dollars, you may want to just hold XEF, VIU, or ZEA in any account type, as they are all relatively tax-efficient choices across all accounts. And last up, emerging markets equity ETFs. In RRSPs and RRSPs, the rules work the same for emerging markets as they do for international equity ETFs. The most tax-efficient structure would either be a US-based ETF that holds emerging market stocks, or a Canadian-based ETF that holds the emerging market stocks directly. In both cases, you avoid the second layer of US withholding tax, so your overall tax drag is around 0.3% per year. Examples of US-based ETFs include the iShares Core MSCI Emerging Markets ETF, with ticker symbol IEMG, and the Vanguard FTSE Emerging Markets ETF, with ticker symbol VWO. Both of these invest in large, mid, and small cap emerging market stocks. The BMO MSCI Emerging Markets Index ETF, with ticker symbol ZEM, is a Canadian-based ETF that holds the majority of the emerging market stocks directly. ZEM only invests in large and mid-cap emerging market stocks, so it's not as diversified as IEMG or VWO. If you instead decided to hold a Canadian-based ETF that holds a US-based ETF that holds emerging market stocks, you could consider the iShares Core MSCI Emerging Markets IMI Index ETF with ticker symbol XEC, which holds IEMG, or the Vanguard FTSE Emerging Markets All Cap Index ETF with ticker symbol VEE, which holds VWO. With either, your withholding tax drag will increase from 0.3% to around 0.6% annually, which is not ideal. In TFSA, RRSP, and RRSP accounts, the most tax-efficient fund structure is a Canadian-based ETF like ZEM, which holds the emerging market stocks directly. It will result in only one layer of withholding taxes, while the other structures will have two layers of tax drag. However, this structure generates other indirect costs. As such, while ZEM's structure is arguably the most tax-efficient from a withholding tax perspective, that doesn't mean it's the optimal structure when all costs are considered. In the past, it has struggled to closely track its index, offsetting most of the benefits from its more tax-efficient structure. For this reason, I still recommend sticking with a Canadian-based ETF that holds a US-based ETF, like VEE or XEC. And last up, in taxable accounts, only one layer of withholding taxes will apply, and may be recoverable if you hold a Canadian-based ETF like ZEM, which holds emerging market stocks directly. There are also US-based ETFs like IEMG or VWO that hold emerging market stocks, or Canadian-based ETFs like XEC or VEE that hold a US-based ETF that holds emerging market stocks. Both of these types will be subject to two layers of withholding taxes, and only the second layer of US withholding tax may be recoverable. Even so, due to the indirect costs of holding ZEM, I've still chosen to hold XEC or VEE in my clients' taxable accounts, at least for the time being. As always, thanks for watching. I'm Justin Bender of PWL Capital, and this is the Canadian Portfolio Manager YouTube channel. If you'd like a summary of the expected foreign withholding tax drags on these and other ETFs, check out my CPM Foreign Withholding Tax Ratio Calculator, available for download on the Canadian Portfolio Manager blog. And if you enjoyed this video, Feel free to also tune into the Canadian Portfolio Manager podcast for more useful investing tips.